Hey, guys.
Hey.
You know what we haven't done in a while?
Make a podcast?
A fucking podcast! So, should we just start going down the list? Because we have three pretty huge lists right now.
Yeah, it has been a pretty damn big... couple weeks.
I have to say, I think Zane's and my list are way better than yours, John. I'm not going to lie here.
I will admit, yours are definitely going to be more fun to tell.
All right. So
yeah. So if you guys want to start out with yours.
Oh, I thought you were starting out because.
Oh, okay. I don't want to start on like a down note.
Okay. Zane, do you want to go first? Or want me to go first?
About. We alternate down our lists. First thing I have on my list is Fallout 4 has recently been released on when we are recording this podcast. And I like it.
Short review?
Wait a minute. I'm going to see how many hours I have played of it since its release.
Yeah, I'm actually really...
21 hours.
Jesus Christ, 21 hours?
Yeah, I know.
It's only been out since Tuesday.
It's only been out. I know. I could have put in more.
Just for the record, we are recording this on a Friday. That's...
What the fuck?
You have classes, though, right?
Do you shower?
Yeah. Dude, on Thursdays, for one, I only have one class.
Okay, yeah, fair. Me too.
And then, like, Tuesdays, I only have two classes, but I went home between the classes since there's, like, a three-hour gap to play Fallout.
How much time did that give you? Like, an hour?
No. Like, I drove, so 3 hours. Or about 3 to 2 hours.
Nice. What's your first impressions of it?
I was a little nervous going into it, because, like, you know, I played Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas and loved both of them, and this one is different. Like, I was really worried about how it was going to be voice acted.
How do you like Codsworth?
I love Codsworth. Codsworth is bae. But no, like, I had him traveling with me at first, and I was like, I'm going to make this robot be my best friend, but every time I talk to him, I'm like, hey, what do you think our relationship status is? He's just like, it's hard to say, sir. You're just so different from how you were 200 years ago. I'm just like, dude,
are you trying
to
bang him?
No.
Are you trying to bang Codsworth?
No, he's not even a romance option.
He's a floating robot.
He's not a romance option in this game, okay?
That's a damn shame.
But if he was, I mean...
Well, the best thing about Codsworth is, it doesn't matter what your name is, he'll say it. So, like, in the beginning when you first find him after you get out of the vault, fucking, if you find him, he'll just be like, oh, Master Titty Sprinkles, how are you doing today?
Yeah, it must be nice having a name where he'll actually call you it. He has not called me Zane.
He hasn't called you Zane? In the very beginning, he didn't call you Zane.
No, with how many names they recorded, I just assume Zane would be one. Because I know it's not a super common name, but it's not, like, it's rare.
Dude, somebody put, like, boob tickler and he said that. How has he not said fucking Zane? Like, really? How has he not said Zane?
Maybe I just haven't been paying attention?
I put Alex in, he's like, oh, hi, Master Alex. I'm like, oh, thanks, man. Next time, I'm going to make a character, I'm just going to name him, like, Anal Rape. Oh, Master Anal Rape, how are you doing today?
That's actually a word in his repertoire.
If he fucking does that and doesn't fucking say Zane, I'm going to die.
There's so many names. You can get him to call you Fuckface, but you can't. He won't say my name.
Fuckface is in our language. Zane, not so much.
Oh, Master Fuckface.
Ah, vaginal warts. No. Good to see you again.
I've been playing a lot. Mostly because I'm not going to be around this weekend, so I'm not going to be able to play this weekend, so I needed to put in my time now. Otherwise, I'm just going to be sitting there the entire weekend going, I want to play Fallout 4.
And selfless plug, you're doing a playthrough of it on the channel that you're doing.
Yes, me and Michael are doing a playthrough. It's kind of a... We're going to try to alternate perspectives. I'm not sure how that's going to go, but either way, we're doing it.
Yeah, I'm interested in seeing like how that would turn out.
Yeah, I need to watch someone else play because I'm pretty shit at the game.
Yeah, we were talking, and we're thinking we're going to alternate views depending on like who's doing something more exciting, because there is a lot of downtime in the game, like if you want to focus on crafting and stuff. And then if we're both doing something exciting, like Michael said, he can do this thing where it has a split to see both of our views at once. It's going to be interesting how it turns out. I don't think it's going to be as popular as others, just single-player ones, but I think it's going to be interesting.
Well, you've kind of already missed the original hype.
Yeah,
I know.
I told you guys you do it the first fucking day. And don't listen.
Dude, we tried, but
I call
the thing is, our class things and schedule and shit didn't exactly line up where we could.
Real talk. How can you not fucking line up with Michael, who literally doesn't go to class and just sits there on his computer all fucking day? How can you not match up with
that? Well, it came out Monday at midnight.
How can you not match up with someone that does
nothing? Tuesday, I had two classes, so I only had
a
3-hour period. And I said, hey, Michael, let's record here. He's like, no, I don't want to. We have to stop within that time limit, even though we only recorded, like, 2 hours anyways when we did record. So, long story short, we know we missed the hype, but we're still doing it because we both love Fallout.
I wouldn't say you missed the hype. It's still happening.
Yeah, it's still happening.
All right, so let me go down my list. My first thing. Well, I gotta skip my first thing because it's gotta come up generically. But shut up.
Well, then why'd you put it on the list?
I put it because it's gotta come up generically. All right, first thing technically on my list would be Pokemon Red and Blue and Yellow. That's coming out on my birthday.
Well, a new release of it's coming out.
Yeah,
on your birthday.
I'm excited for it. I didn't know that they were adding orange and pink and rainbow.
Yeah.
What?
That's the new generation.
Oh, orange, pink, rainbow, nice.
I was adding to his list of topics.
but I'm super excited for that because I'm a Gen 1 Pokemon person. I also spit all over my face while saying that. But, yeah.
Yeah, like, see, you guys are talking about really good stuff, and then, like, most of mine is just... Like, my first thing I have on my list is how much I fucking hate Final Cut. So, for one of my classes, we have to go and work at, like, an actual newsroom, but we were just doing some practice editing, and part of that practice editing is working with their systems and their servers and stuff. They work on Final Cut, and for the past 2 years, I have been using Premiere exclusively, so... Literally everything in my workflow was broken. Everything, literally, just the way that things moved annoyed me. The way that things clipped annoyed me. So one of the biggest pet peeves was Final Cut automatically just snapping everything together. And
yeah, it's kind of a bitch.
Yeah. So it snaps everything together automatically. So like you don't have any blank space unless you delete something. And then you just get a fucking dark box that you can't do anything with. Like, you can't hit delete to delete that. The keys are definitely something that, like, is my own fault, because, like, I'm so used to just hitting, like, C for cut. No, it's B for blade. And then I'm so used to hitting V to go back to the select tool. But no, V just toggles whether or not something in the timeline's visible. So, in general, probably the worst experience I've had editing for 6 hours total. And thank God I don't have to do it anymore until maybe next semester.
Wait, so you only use Premiere. Have you ever used Vegas or anything like that?
No, I used Movie Edit Pro, and before that, like, obviously Windows Movie Maker. So, like,
come on, Movie Maker!
Exactly. Those are the two.
Yeah, that's what I use. God damn it. I was waiting for John to stop talking so I could go, oh, that's why I use Windows Movie Maker. But no, Alex, you had to steal the joke.
Well, fucking hurry it up then.
I didn't want to interrupt John.
God, why don't you show me on the dial where I touched you?
Right there.
That's still kind of forced.
That was the first thing on my list.
But yeah, I used Movie Edit Pro, which had the exact same mechanics like as Final Cut. Like, I could have as many layers as I wanted. I could do whatever I needed to with blank space, so that way I could work on video that's like to the right instead of having to work it with some bullshit teeny little area in the top left. And I just really don't get how people do that, because like you can do that in Premiere too, but why would you do that? Just work with it in the timeline. Like, I even got complimented at how fast I edited yesterday for one of our class assignments, and like, no, I can't. It literally took me like 3 hours to finish a 2-minute video that's already been done and that I can reference just because I'm trying to figure out what the hell I'm doing.
Wow, only 3 hours?
Have you said, hey, I know how to actually edit with something else. Can I use that instead?
I don't think they had Premiere on their computers.
But you had Premiere.
I'm not going to break out my laptop and connect it to their system.
Just be like, hey, yo.
That and a lot of their assets just wouldn't work or couldn't connect if I did. The way that they had the stuff set up, like all their servers were on like their own stuff. So, and then they had custom Final Made intros, music, stuff that is specifically just already in the Final Cut library. So I just edited through the pain.
Lame.
All right, Zane.
It was not enjoyable.
Zane, what's the second thing on your list? Oh, wait, you crossed out your second thing. No, you gotta.
My second thing on my list was also Fallout 4, but someone crossed out all of Fallout 4. No. Maybe I wanted to talk about Fallout 4 a lot.
Yeah, talk about Fallout 4 some more.
Okay, I like it.
So what else you gotta say about Fallout 4?
Because you wrote it 5 times.
I'm just going to go to the next thing.
All right, here. No. No, you go to my next one. My next one's Fallout 4 as well. So,
you haven't even played the other two.
Hold on. No, don't you fucking touch my shit. No.
I'm just crossing that shit we've talked about.
So my Fallout 4, I've been playing as much as you, but I also have played it. It's a cool game. I never played any of the Fallouts before, so this is my first Fallout 4.
The gunplay is a lot better in this one.
Oh, nice. Oh, that's great. I don't know what shit is in the game. Every fucking time I go in, I always like, all right, what are the fucking controls? Because these controls are bullshit.
they're not that bad. I mean, control to sneak, that's pretty standard.
Left alt for power punch? Really? Left alt?
You never use it anyways. It's fine.
Yeah, I never use it because it's so inconvenient to use. I had to go out of my way.
It's
to push
so inconvenient
that
to move your thumb from the space to the alt.
Yeah, it really is.
I'd give it to you. That's counterintuitive, but I don't think it's inconvenient.
I'd rather it be like a number two on my. It's like what?
But that's for your quick select where you can.
Yeah.
Quick
let me tell
weapons.
You. I also don't fucking use that either because it's easier just to hold F. Except for when it fucked me the one time where some raiders were in front of me and they see me and they're running at me. I was like, all right, I got my gun and I went to go use the bat and I actually hit F and shit fucking stim pack comes up and now he's like running at me. I was like, fuck. And my guy shoves the stim pack in his arm while he's getting beaten by a guy. I'm like, no, you fucking bitch. Get off me. So then I had to fucking pull out my gun and blast his head off and then I don't know if you do this, but this is very important to me. Every body I loot thoroughly. As in, if you go into a city where I killed everyone, you'll see a bunch of dead bodies on the ground with no clothes on. They're all naked on the ground.
You're a hoarder and a pervert.
Yes, exactly.
And no audience, if you are not interested in Fallout, you're not the only one. I haven't really been paying attention.
I can't wait till Zane's third topic on his list.
And his fourth. And his fifth.
Look, we're getting Fallout 4 out of the way now, so you can just like not pay attention to the first part, and then we'll talk about other things. Like, I'll stop talking about Fallout 4, and I'll start talking about the week that me and my roommates had a cat.
Okay,
yeah.
Yeah, like I don't have too much to say on it. It's just like we found this stray cat pretty much in our driveway. So we brought it inside, like gave it some food, blah, blah, blah. And we thought, okay, we might be able to raise it. And like at first, you know, it was cute having a cat around. But then the cat got really annoying because it keeps meowing at me while I'm in my room. And it wouldn't shut up.
Meow, meow, motherfucker.
And there's just that one point I realized we can't keep this cat because no one wants to cover like the vet bills.
Yeah.
So
wait, where did you?
I started to stop paying attention to the cat because I was like,
"What?"
I would give it some attention, but it was just like I wasn't smothering it like I was before because I didn't want the cat to feel betrayed when we finally got rid of it.
Oh, so you've become an asshole to the cat. So it wants
I wasn't an asshole to the cat. I still gave it food.
Take the cat while it's down.
No, I just stopped petting it every time it demanded attention.
Oh, I want to be real close to you. Fuck off, you fucking whore. Get away from me.
Pretty much. The cat was in heat.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God, yes.
I remember when my cat was.
Meow.
Would not. Yeah.
Meow.
Yeah, we'll
meow.
Not shut up. We'll not
meow.
Leave you alone.
Meow.
Meow.
But, don't worry. The story has a happy ending. Because, my roommate's boyfriend's grandmother took the cat.
Oh, did she like how it was in heat?
Probably. I don't know how long he has, but like I said, we had it for like a week until we realized we can't do it.
Okay, John, you have real news that isn't like gaming or anything, so go for that.
Or about the cat.
Or about fucking bullshit.
I don't even know, like, you guys might just want to talk about more of your stuff, because basically everything I have on my list, besides like the last point, is like its own clump. Like, it's all intertwined, and like, I don't know how I'd tell some of it without the others.
Yeah, and it's pretty depressing.
Yeah, all right, I have an idea. How about Alex, we'll alternate, go through the rest of our list, and then I have an idea for while John is going through his list.
My next thing is Halo 5. It came out, 2 weeks ago? Halo 5?
I don't know.
All right, well, it came out like 2 weeks ago, and obviously I bought it when it came out because I'm a huge fucking Halo fan.
Did you just change your font to Comic Sans?
No.
Wait,
you did.
Wait, I wonder if it has my text, whatever. So as I was saying, Halo 5. It's great. I love Halo 5. The issue is I've beaten it already, and I need to beat it again on Legendary. And then I had to beat it again with a friend on Legendary, and I don't have any friends. So that's kind of an issue. But it's a really fun game, and it was pretty easy to beat the first time.
Me and Michael were watching you, and you died a lot.
You watched me the one time, but that was the first level, and I beat the first level on Legendary. A lot harder than it looked like, but it was...
It's been really hard for me and Michael just yelling about how we don't like the game while you were playing.
Yeah, you guys are trying to make fun of me.
Not you, of the game.
But the game's great!
But it's not Halo 1, 2, or 3, so I need to bitch about it.
Honestly, this game is probably one of the best Halo games since, for like the longest time,
you.
Actually. No, you haven't fucking played it! You're trying to make up this fucking... Okay, you're making up a fruit fucking excuse. Oh, it's a shitty fucking game. You haven't even fucking played
it.
I don't think it's
actually shitty. I just...
It's really good. You play as a black guy for most of it.
And you say that improved the experience for you?
Yeah. Well, you also play as the white guy, too.
Fucking white people.
Hey, I'm the darkest one here. I take offense by that.
I said white people.
Exactly. Would you like to go to the next thing on your list?
All right, anyways, another game that came out literally right before Fallout 4. Not a game, but like an add-on to a game. Binding of Isaac Rebirth had the Afterbirth expansion come out, and it's fucking hard.
It's Binding of Isaac.
Yeah, but it's like, you can get... When you play Binding of Isaac enough, you can get to the point where most runs, like, solid above 75%, you'll win. But now, Binding of Isaac Afterbirth just made everything harder, like, even the earlier floors, added new bosses and shit, and it's just like, oh god, now, this is the first time I've died on the second floor in forever.
See, I feel like that's a terrible name for a game, because Afterbirth. Fucking Afterbirth. Do you really want to be playing a game? It's like, oh yeah, it's the shit that comes out the vagina.
Are you not familiar with Binding of Isaac, though? Like, even I am, and I haven't played it.
No.
Binding of Isaac's kind of fucked up.
It doesn't look like a fun game to me. It looks really boring to me.
Look, some people have fun with it, and some people don't. Like, I understand that. But this is like a game that has more of a cult following, where it's like people start to like it, and all of a sudden it's just like a game. It's either a game you play all the time or not at all.
And then they meet in groups and start killing people?
Yeah, no, you don't get it. In Binding of Isaac, you fucking cry to kill things. You kill poop, you kill messed up shit. Like, it's not a game like, oh yeah, this is fun or cool. It's like, it can be kind of sick, but you just have fun with it. It's like, oh my god, I just killed my mom. Cool.
You know what's really depressing? Like, this is getting a little off topic, but it has to do with things that are depressing. Fucking the Peanuts.
Like the cartoon or comics?
Like the new movie.
Yeah, like the cartoon. If you actually think about it, it's fucking depressing.
Like, he is sad a lot, Charlie Brown.
Yeah, he's sad. Fucking, he gets beaten up by fucking girl. And then fucking, it's just a messed up fucking...
Does getting a football pulled out from under you constitute a beating?
She also punches him.
It's been so long since I've seen it.
And she gives him shitty fucking advice.
Hell yeah.
Like, I think the only time that I've seen that's, like, in school. In, like, elementary school.
Really?
Yeah.
Dude, I love, like, the Charlie Brown movies.
It also brings the topic because, what was it, the other day when, Black Ops 3 came out, another great game came out. It's Snoopy's Adventure or something like that. It's the Peanuts game for the Xbox One came out. Looks fucking fantastic, not gonna lie. You play as Snoopy and Woodstock, and you have to save the children.
Cool. So, I believe it's called Snoopy's Grand Adventure.
It's something like, I don't remember the name. Yeah, but Snoopy's Grand Adventure. Pretty cool. You can get hats.
Snoopy Dog.
It's only $39.99 on Wii U, but it's $49.99 on PS4 and Xbox One.
I don't know, but I think it's given a Fallout 4 a run for its money.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Was that a snicker?
A little bit, yes.
What was that? All right. The next thing on my list, I don't really know how to get into, so I'm just gonna skip that one. And
yeah, I'm kind of curious why you wrote that down.
He just writes down random stuff that pops into his head.
I was like, I saw it, but it was in the middle of his list. So I was like, is this something he's actually going to talk about, or is this just him fucking around?
He was writing stuff that he thought, and then just...
So there's an agenda that's going on here. No, so I should probably talk about this. I don't know if you guys can tell, I'm using a different mic. I got a fucking amazing microphone from Samson.
Are they paying you to say that?
No, actually they're not.
Okay, because if they're paying you, you have to tell us. It's the law.
Dude, if they were paying me, I'd be fucking happy about it. They even,
so you're saying you're sad right now?
No, I'm happy they sent me this microphone because it's a kick-ass mic. If they gave me money on top, bitches, I'd be fucking happy. But but no, it's actually a really amazing mic. It's the MTR 201, which is really cool. And I think, John, you're going to be getting...
Yeah, I just need to respond to the dang email. I've been so busy this week. I can't pay attention in Skype. I don't know why. I can't write in Skype at the same time.
Yeah, so essentially what they're trying to do is they're, you know, trying to talk to a bunch of gamers and shit. And John and I are gamers.
Yeah.
I'm Zane.
Oh, you know, Zane. And apparently we're funny enough to have free shit thrown at us. Bullshit. So, yeah.
Yeah.
But no, it's actually legitimately awesome, and I'm really happy about it.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds really good. Like, I'm excited if I get the same kind of deal.
Well, I would assume so. And it actually has this really cool... So it comes with a shock mount, a little pop filter, which I'm really shocked about, which is really awesome. It comes with a nice carrying case, and it has the ability to change it from, you know, normal settings to negative 10 decibels. If you fucking say dB, you're fucking asshole.
Well, hey, I have a negative 10 dB on mine.
Decibel. It's decibel. It's a fucking decibel.
Interesting that you said a pop filter there, because that brings me to the question. Do you guys say soda pop or soda pop?
It's a soda filter. Come on, Zane. Everybody knows this.
No, I'm talking about the beverage.
So are you saying, do people say soda pop or soda pop?
Yeah, like from
or some
from
for where, some reason Coke.
From where you're around, what do people say, and what do you and your family say? Like,
it depends on how old you are.
Okay, like what do you say?
I say soda.
I say soda. You know, a lot of my family says soda, but as soon as you go to like my grandmother on my dad's side, she calls it pop or soda pop. Mostly soda pop. When I was younger, I used to say soda pop because, you know,
you were a fucking idiot.
No. I like the 50s.
I just loved your scream. No, like, you're an idiot. No!
Don't put that on me.
This is not... This is not preferred!
No, like... I know, when I was younger, I used to say pop all the time. Because, like, oh yeah, I'd like a pop. But now it's like... One day I started saying soda. And I don't know why or how this happened.
I just imagine, like, oh yeah, like a pop, and someone pulls their thumb out and shoves it up your butt. Good day.
Perfect.
What?
I don't know.
Oh my god. That has to go back to my old thing that, on my list, right before a new mic.
Yes, the homeless schedule.
The homeless schedule.
It's a little...
Just steal that joke from
there. Hey, Zane.
Yeah?
Why don't you show me on the doll where I touched you?
Now, see, that's more natural.
Yeah, I did it!
This is a girl doll.
It'll have to work. Just put a sausage on it.
Just touch it. Slower.
Higher. Higher.
What the fuck are we doing?
Oh, yes. Right.
Next on the list. No. Oh, Extra Life, man.
Oh yeah, that thing. I know you...
So Extra Life is a charity thing that happened last weekend. Rooster Teeth does a 24-hour live stream for it, trying to raise as much money. I donated some money because I love to fucking help children in need. You fucking assholes out there didn't fucking donate to the fucking cause. Oh no, it's really good though. But no, it's a really good cause. And it's all about, you know, helping children in hospitals and stuff like that. So I donated some money. I hope you guys donated some money.
Yeah, if you donate, it's good, but it's understandable if you don't. Like, you need to be able to afford things still. If you're someone who's, like, just living paycheck to paycheck or just doesn't have very much money, like, you're fine. But yeah, if you're someone who's I'm rolling in the cash, like, if you are aware of that cause and watched a stream but did not donate and you have plenty of capital where it's not even a worry. But otherwise, like, no pressure.
No, it's, like, it's really cool because people donate a lot of money. Like,
yeah, it's fucking insane.
A lot of people, like, you just see, like, $1,000. I seen, like, a couple $5,000. Like, Jesus Christ, that's amazing. I don't know how you're able to afford that, but...
I want to be able to afford that someday.
Yeah, I would love to be able to.
Because, one, I'm donating to a cause, and, two, I'm showing people on the internet, look at me, I have money.
Yeah. So, you skipped a few of your topics. The one below The Binding of Isaac. Would you like to talk about that one?
That is a personal traumatizing event.
So Zane's been drowning.
Yes, and I have drowned recently.
And it's weird that you're still fine.
I got better.
How was the experience?
Wet.
It was quite wet. Well, now, was it like a bunch of cats that like were they affecting the situation?
It was just like a bunch of cats that have recently been in water, and they just, like, lay it on my face, and I started to drown.
Mm. So it's like waterboarding, but with cats.
Yeah.
So these cats, or these pussy cats,
yep,
were trying to drown you. So you were drowning these pussies.
Yes, I drowned in the pussy
cat. You drowned in the pussy.
In the wet pussy cat, yes.
Okay, you drowned the pussy.
Yes.
Well, now that joke's out of the way.
Now let's go to my joke. So somebody, I don't really remember... this me putting this here, but it says struggles of having a small dick. So
yeah,
apparently I've been having issues. I didn't even know about this, but underneath of it says struggles of shoving that small dick into an even smaller vagina. So
yeah.
I don't even know how to go from
there. This podcast is run by a bunch of straight males.
This podcast is sponsored with you by Viagra. Pop some pills, yo.
Popping
this,
pills for
podcast
a
is sponsored by small dicks.
This is sponsored by Extra Life.
Oh, God.
I can't do that.
No, we're actually sponsored by Second Life.
Second Life? Oh, my
That's
God.
That's a lie.
It's actually sponsored by YouPorn. Where Zane uploads his videos.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. I'm surprised I don't have very many subscribers. I make a ton of videos.
Nobody watches them.
All right, go. Since we're talking about videos, I put Left 4 Dead down because I started a series and added you assholes into the series.
Wait,
and
when?
Another person.
I don't remember this.
Are you fucking with me right now, dude?
I remember, Left 4 Dead 2.
A little bit.
But...
yeah, Left 4 Dead 2.
Oh. Well, you gotta clarify.
Left 4 Dead 2! Okay, so I'm doing a thing where we're running all of Left 4 Dead 2 on Expert. It's pretty great. you motherfucker. So if you haven't seen the video, John's going to put a link in the thingy for the thing. So why the new one? Because it's really good. Okay.
That font is fancy as fuck.
Yes, thank you. So, the new video I think is definitely one of my favorite videos I've done recently in general. So I fucking love it. So definitely check it out.
Fun. Yeah, seriously, like yeah, I'm in it, so I might be biased, but that's seriously like Alex, you did a great job editing that.
Thank you. I spent so much time editing it.
Made me look funny.
That's what I try to do. I try to make everyone sound funny.
John's just screaming.
Yeah, half of it's just like, oh my god.
It's a good thing that someone on my Steam is now playing Google Chrome. Didn't know that was a thing, but okay.
You can launch any program through it.
I've been having these invites from people on Steam, and their names are just numbers.
Those might be bots.
But they have pictures.
Bots can have pictures. See Tinder.
One of them is an anime girl, and the other is the face from V for Vendetta, whatever that face is called, Anonymous or whatever.
So, V.
I legitimately get like real people that send me try to invite me all the time, and it was a really bad idea to invite or to accept a bunch of them because I did it because I got really pissed off with seeing the number there, and I feel bad for ignoring them.
These people are from China or some Asian country trying to add me. I guess I'm popular among the Asian demographic.
Yeah, but yeah, Alex, do you know that there's just a little minus button for the invites?
Wait, what?
You can just hit the minus button, and then all the invites will just be collapsed down.
No, not that. I'm talking about the. I'm talking about like when I open up Steam, where it has like the messages thing. It just has like a flashing green number.
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
It's always every single time I open it, and it sucks. I feel bad, and I, you know, this is gonna make me sound like pretentious, but oh shit. Can you edit that word out?
You are what you eat.
Oh god.
You can keep it in, but like edit just that word out.
Okay, one second. Let me put that as a note.
I'll type it in. But it's gonna make me seem like that, but if I didn't start adding like random people, my friends thing would be like 50 invites and it'd be really bad.
Yeah, that no. Like I went and then like ignored a bunch of the invites I got and I have like 8 of them right now.
I have 9 right now, but like a week ago I had like 20.
But yeah, just like a word, at least like my policy when it comes to Steam or Skype is like if I have really any reason to talk to you or like play games with you, then yeah, I'll add you. But if not, like probably not.
Skype is very is gonna be very hard for you to get on my Skype. I don't add people very much anymore because I got burned. But I think on Steam now I have like 80 some odd friends because of it, or like something like that.
Dude, I had everyone who sends me a Skype thing. I love talking to bots.
No. Bots are one thing. None of these are bots.
Let me just look at my profile because I have, last time I checked, it was like 140 something contact. 177. Wow.
On Steam?
On Skype. Skype, yeah.
Holy crap.
Yeah.
I have nowhere near that much.
Like, most of the people I probably, like, have done YouTube business with them at one point or something. You go to, where did it go? Skype, profile, edit your profile, and then show full profile. And then it's towards the bottom.
Oh, I have 100 contacts.
Yeah, I have a lot, but like my Skype is reaching back all the way to like the email that I used when I first got on the internet.
Oh, nice.
Like it's at SW Bell, which is when like my parents still had AT&T for our ISP.
Oh my god.
Which was like probably a decade ago at this point. At least. Yeah, it's definitely a decade ago because Club Penguin's like getting almost to
Club
a decade
Penguin.
Anniversary
okay,
for
Club
me.
Penguin.
Oh yeah, that's something we can talk about on the next podcast.
Whoa. Hold on. There's someone on Skype that I haven't seen on Skype in forever. You guys all know him.
Mom?
He's the infamous
Eclipse.
Page R.
Pager. Rager.
I just sent him a message wondering if it's really him.
Yeah, so if you watch my videos, at least back in the day, I used to do quite a few vids with Paige.
He's a pretty cool guy.
He's a nice dude, but he doesn't show up.
Yeah, he's just kind of fallen off the face of the earth at random times nowadays.
I think I've talked to him 3 or 4 times.
No, but he knows what you look like.
Oh, yeah.
Who doesn't know what you...
Yeah.
Should send him more pictures.
Who doesn't know what Zane looks like? He's the like profile picture for every one of our group chats and stuff like that. And like your banana pirate costume is the group chat picture for server chat.
We were going to talk about Halloween a bit, even though that happened like 2 weeks ago almost.
But it still happened since the last time we recorded a podcast, so...
I actually dressed up for Halloween. I got a banana costume, and the whole thing I'm going to do with it is I'm going to be a different banana-based thing every Halloween now. And last year, I was a banana pirate.
God.
Do you have plans for your next?
My dad had a really fun suggestion that I should just carry a hammock around and be a banana hammock.
That's not what that means.
It's a pun on words, John.
No, it's actually what it is.
Don't Google it if you're underage.
If you're underage though.
If you are underage, why just are go watch Scrubs.
If you're underage, why are you even listening to this?
That is a good thing to note, but it's in Scrubs. If it's in Scrubs, I'm like it's somewhat PG.
Hey, I have a question. How are you under the age? Like
you haven't been born yet.
Oh, okay.
I mean, like, if you're not comfortable hearing the following words, okay, John, at this bit, you're just going to bleep out everything I'm saying here so it sounds like I'm swearing a lot, and then we're going to be back now. Then you really
bitch,
shouldn't be listening
tits,
to
damn,
this.
Ass.
No, you're not really supposed to start swearing.
Bitch, tits, damn, ass.
I'm noting that to do some editing.
I almost want you to just leave that whole thing.
Filthy, disgusting penguin.
Son of a cat.
Should I just start getting into my list?
Well, unless you want me to continue my list, because I have more stuff on mine.
Go for it.
Okay, this next thing I'm going to save for a little bit later. Thing after that, Potter World, you fucked my asshole.
Again?
So... No, you were there. So, I'm going to explain what happened. We were going to record, and all my stuff was gone. Literally.
Just gone.
Everything. My spells, everything. I restarted. I still need to get a hold of Dribbledore and see if he can fix that for me. Help me out. But,
maybe Dribbledore will listen to our podcast.
No. He's seen my videos, though. So, you know, whatever. So, I'm going to see if he can help me out. But... I lost literally everything, and it took me like 20 minutes just to get standard stuff. But when I got my map still had everything on it. It was really weird. So
yeah, it sounds like a glitch with your player profile, but like that can still be fine elsewhere. Like I know when it comes to like essentials, that saves its own little profile thing. So like those can be unaffected when your profile gets messed up and. I don't know. Something Man, obviously messed up.
Oh no, I've crashed.
Did I crash or something?
And I'm still recording.
Whatever do I do? Well,
I am going to keep talking.
I can't hear what's going on right now in the call.
Because
so
I thought that was a dramatic pause.
Back.
Hello? Hello?
Hi.
What just happened?
I was about to monologue since I wasn't in the call.
You monologued?
Yeah, I monologued
too. I was about
too.
To, but I didn't have enough time.
I monologued.
Okay, we'll keep that then for your side.
Okay. I was like, John, you know things.
Well, now I'm curious.
Nah, it wasn't much. But, yeah, so Potter World fucked my asshole with that, but hopefully they can unfuck my asshole.
Yeah, because you have recordings of your stuff, like... You can just
send... I have constant recordings. I do a series on it every week.
Exactly. Just send them a video just like, this is what I had. It'd be great if you could get me it back.
Yeah.
And they'll see that you're recording on it consistently and maybe do something about it like that.
Well, I think... Well, Dribbledore knows because I send him stuff like, hey, yo, how do you like me doing things? and he was like super awesome about it. But yeah, there's that. Next thing on my list, because you know we're saving John's for last, because John, you know, is.
Yeah. It'll probably take the longest to explain and be the least relevant when this podcast goes out. So
yeah, so you know, well, when is coming out? Like 4 years.
Hopefully by the end of the year.
when you guys are actually here. Which one? All right, I'll go to Pizza Pie Za. So, it's weird because, and this is something you learn, I guess, it's pretty weird, I guess. I've grown up and lived on the East Coast my entire life, where pizza is a huge deal here. And it was really odd for me to hear about how it's not, like, you know, as big, you know, in Central or Western as much. Like, people like it and all, but it doesn't taste as good as the pizza here.
Oh, shit. We got to get some pizza while we're there then, John.
Yeah, which is weird.
Yeah, we should.
Like, and the thing that's weird to me is when people don't understand when you're talking about pie. Like, because I made this joke yesterday when we were talking. And I was talking about pie, and, you know, and Zane thought I was talking about the number pie. And John, I think you're thinking I was talking about like a pie, like a dessert. I was talking about pizza.
Yeah.
So
yeah, I've heard people call it pizza pie before, but I just thought that was
pizza
fake.
Pie, pizza, pie, za. You know, these are like all words for pizza.
I know pizza. I know za.
I don't believe you on za. What the fuck?
Za is an actual term.
Dude. What?
I'm not even joking. Za's a word. It's pizza.
It's like when you call Qdoba.
Yeah, but
Doba.
If you said it as za, that might make more sense if you're talking slang for pizza. But za? Pizza?
Yeah.
How does that make any sense?
Like David will be like, yeah, I'm getting my son some za. I'm like, okay, I know what that is. Well, I'm assuming because za is usually just cheese pizza.
Damn.
That's
actually a thing that originated in the 60s.
How did you not know this?
How the fuck would I know that?
It's za!
Don't you ever just call pizza za for fun?
No.
How the fuck have you lived?
By just calling it pizza!
Okay, so you guys are coming here in a month-ish, a little bit more than a month. I am going to make sure you have pizza. Real pizza.
I can't eat cheese.
Not this bullshit you guys eat. Wait, what?
I'm allergic to dairy. Did it get really quiet because of shock or?
John, you're gonna have to do something.
What? You're gonna have him kill me on the road and then
take
my car?
Are you serious? You can't fucking eat pizza?
I can eat pizza. I just can't have cheese on it.
Is like, that even a pizza?
No, it's like ass. You're eating human ass right there. That
is like
what you
breadsticks
do.
With marinara
you
sauce.
A piece of ass on your
Maybe
plate.
I would like breadsticks with marinara sauce, John.
Zane!
No. This actually comes out with a funny story. Like, I normally need to get stuff to actually make pizza good, like pepperoni, mushroom, like all sorts of different things. But there's this one time that I was out with the school thing, and like they ordered pizza for like my group of people, so they had to get one specifically for me, but they forgot to get anything on it, so it was just
bread.
The bread and the sauce, that was it. It was
that's
the most
what I
disappointing
assume
pizza.
That you eat. That's what I assume.
No,
you eat
I get shit on it.
No, it doesn't count. You don't have cheese.
Well, sorry,
Zane. Do something about your issues. Take a pill or something. I don't care. You gotta eat pizza like normal person.
I can't. I'll die.
What? No.
Yeah.
Inject yourself with super steroids. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm looking on Urban Dictionary. Za, really obnoxious word for pizza that no self-respecting person uses.
What are you
using it in a sentence? Next person to call it za is getting kicked in their nis. Is nis another word for nuts?
Me and my friends say za all the time, like ironically, like, bro, do you want to get some za?
Like, you've never just called it za.
Yeah, no self-respecting person.
Well, maybe I'm not self-respecting.
Does anyone
you ever think of that, John?
Bro, calm down.
I'm talking in this podcast right now. Shows you how much respect I have for myself right now.
How lazy are you that you can't pronounce the extra syllable?
Pretty fucking lazy.
It's like 2K15, 2015. It's the same fucking amount. What? You're just being... It's the kids that are wrong these days.
It's the kids. For the kids, obviously.
Fuck the kids.
Whoa, I mean...
As in, like... Is that your agenda? Just like them, not as in...
Is
illegal.
That your agenda, Zane?
We should just...
How many times have you seen Serbian film, man?
Sorry, just put that in as the beginning. Fuck the kids.
There's no good way you can just say, like, insult the children, because it always sounds worse than... If I were just go like, God, fuck you, Alex. Like, people are just like, oh, he's just saying fuck you, whatever. But if I say fuck you, kid, or, like, fuck the kids, then it sounds like I'm a pedophile.
No, if you say fuck you, kid, that sounds like you're saying, like, I
hate
this kid.
What if I want to, like, have the entire group of children fuck you?
Fuck you guys.
Wait, what?
Fuck you, children.
Did I hear that wrong, or did I hear that right?
I tried to phrase it right so you couldn't go, you want to fuck a group of children, because I don't.
It's all in the inflection.
I don't even want to think of his inflection.
I'm just saying that I should be able to say fuck kids and have it be someone think, oh, this guy doesn't like kids.
So can this week's podcast be called... Whizzler Zane fucks kids?
No.
No.
Nothing that makes me sound like a pedophile. I'm not.
I mean,
a virgin.
Okay, I mean, you didn't have this. Okay, John, can you bleep that out?
I'm a...
Please, I would make that sound so much funnier.
I'll put it on the list.
Yes.
You guys are going to make me sound like a horrible person, and then I'm going to get arrested.
For what?
Being a pedophile on the internet.
I mean, you're not the only person.
They're disgusting people.
Whoa.
What?
They're actual people, Zane. You're making fun of people. So, how dare you? You
know, people can be bad, Alex.
Zane, they have rights too. They have rights too.
Yeah.
They're allowed...
Their right does not include
the freedom of speech.
Boys,
yes, it does.
Boys. No.
Because America...
No,
America.
You're not free to diddle children.
I didn't say anything about diddling them. I said they have the they are self people.
Yes, they're people, but people can be bad, Alex.
Maybe for you.
Okay, I'm gonna let's talk
oh
about
God.
Something else.
Zane fucks kids this week.
Did you guys know that Pornhub reported a 10% drop in traffic the day that Fallout 4 came out?
I love fucking stats on Pornhub.
Please, can somebody make a Fallout 4 video for Pornhub?
No. Before Fallout 4 came out, somebody leaked a video of Fallout 4 gameplay on Pornhub.
Oh my God.
That's great.
Pornhub reports a 10% traffic drop the day Fallout 4 comes out. Oh, they actually have a graph.
Oh my God,
yeah.
Graph?
I've heard a lot of news stories about their traffic and like some of their stats. Like, it's surprisingly amusing.
How weird would that be just to work at Pornhub and your job was to just watch how many people on average are watching porn?
Imagine they don't have somebody sitting there watching
10%
stats.
Less people watch porn today.
That sounds like a great job.
Apparently the world's most popular porn site.
So I've heard and never done
it's
research on said website.
Job just to sit there and go like, oh, not as many people masturbating today.
You think it's someone's job to sit there and just watch the videos and have to like, oh, this was a little too offensive, let's flag it?
No, I doubt it.
Just imagine that person on Christmas just looking and like, oh, wow, we had a spike this year in people.
I think there is somebody in China that's their job, though, is to watch through and just find stuff to flag.
That's either a great job or a terrible job. I can't really decide.
After a while, I imagine it'd just be hell.
Next on the list.
Right, Rwby.
I was gonna say that for last.
Okay, we can do it. So
songwriting. Songwriting's hard by yourself, man. And no, it really is.
That's why there's so many bands.
Yeah, but usually they're working with a bunch of people. See, my issue is the bass player I play with and the drummer I play with live almost a fucking hour away. So it's a pain in the ass sometimes to get together.
Well, I've been replacing them with robots.
Yeah, exactly. So when it comes to actually like needing to like write shit, it seems like I'm the one that's just coming up with everything at the moment because I don't know why.
What I know, Alex, is like you are very passionate about music. Like, it's a huge thing in your life, and I just don't know. Like, I think music's going to be important to your bandmates. I just don't know if they're going to be on the same level as you, because I swear, you talk about music, like, every other day, if not every day.
I talk about it every day, first off. Second, well, the drummer, literally, this is what he does. He works from around 6 a.m. and gets off around 3 p.m., and then from 3:30 to 9 o'clock, he drums. That's literally every day for him.
He should quit his job and just drum all day.
And then bass player, you know, he's definitely not. He's like huge into music and all, but he doesn't spend as much time as us two.
Right.
But I'm always with music. I have guitars usually within 50 feet of me. I have a fucking music room in my basement. It is a huge deal for me.
I'm expecting us just to show up at your house and there's going to be guitars on every wall.
Not every wall, most walls though. Well, not every, I should say most. In the basement, there's there's only three walls right now that's got guitars on them. I think. No, four. Yeah, four. Three in the basement, one in my room.
I mean, that does make a little more sense because, like, your family also plays.
Well, no, only my dad.
Just your dad? Okay.
Yeah, it's just me and my dad. I play lead, and my dad's a bass player.
What does your nephew play?
I try. He likes to bang on the drums, but, you know, he's only three. Attaboy. He's only three. I'm trying to teach him beats, but, you know.
Just teach him how to beatbox.
No, not going to do that. I tried to teach. I wanted my brother to learn how to drum because I wanted him to be a drummer. Because it'd be so much easier to work with a drummer that lives in the same house as you.
Right.
But he is the best way he's a drummer is when he's drunk. And when he's drunk, he's not good.
Already a rock star.
No, even when he's drunk, he's not good. But it's fun to write because I write a lot of. I usually write instrumentals because that's like the easiest thing for me. But it's really.
How do you write those?
You sit there. I don't
write the notes.
No, I can't read music.
Really?
No, not at all. I can't read music at all.
That's the only musical talent I have, and that's only for like bass clef.
Like
same here, but with trumpet.
I used to be able to read when I was younger because I used to play trumpet, saxophone.
I used to be able to read.
No, it's true. It's like I used to be. I can't read music at all. This chick tried to teach me. About a year ago, she was like telling me stuff about it, and I was like, I really don't see the point when I can just hear something and play it, or just think of it in my head like, and it comes out.
I'm kind of jealous of that. I suck with music.
Well, it's like, I developed this in high school where I was able to think of something in my head and then it would just come out.
Right, like, I find that admirable. Like, I can't do that straight up. Can't do it.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know. There's just, like, something in my mind. Like, I always overthink things, and it's just, like, I'm not musically talented. I can't just, like, pick up an instrument, mess around with it, and then come up with, like, a cool song or beat or anything.
See, that's where you and I differ. I can, like, I'll come home some days from class and be like, oh, man, I really need to do, I need to relax. And then I'll just go downstairs and hop on a drum set and I'll come up with some beats. Or,
like,
or I'll pick up a bass and just come up with some grooves or stuff like that.
The most impressive thing I've done musically is I accidentally started playing Reptilla while fucking around on my violin.
But and didn't you learn the middle eighth? You were doing the middle eighth, the na 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 na.
Yeah, it's like I had the beginning bit and then that bit. Like I originally started playing like the middle bit.
Or the chorus, I guess would be considered because it's middle eighth to chorus.
You know, sort of da 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 da.
These are music terms.
Yeah, I don't actually understand what any of those words are. I just know where it is.
Best thing is, I've never taken a real music class.
Nice.
As music classes are for posers.
Well, like I took in college, I took a popular music of the U.S. class, which because it was like I had to do something like that, and then like in elementary school, I did like a music thing to learn saxophone. Other than that, I've never taken music. Everything has just been teaching myself.
That is some of the best ways to learn, I think.
Oh, it's definitely the best way because then you're not pressured into doing things. Specifically, you do things like, how you want to do them.
Look at me. I was in band from fifth grade all the way through high school. Plus, I took a violin class in college, and I don't know shit about music.
Yeah, see, where I didn't do any of that, and if you say, all right, play a lick in the key of A, I can do that. I'll just make up something.
Yeah, I have no idea what that
means. Well, a lick would be just some type of, you know.
Do you lick the guitar?
Exactly. No, it's a riff. Just make up some type of riff, and in
a
the
riff,
key of
I've heard that term before.
And the key of A would be, you know, you're staying everything within the tuning of, you know, an A. It's just something that has come very natural to me. When it's funny because when I first started playing, I was like, "What the hell is this?" I'll just strum everything open string. Do, 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 do. It's like I'll figure music out this way, which it doesn't turn out. But it is great to learn things of your own accord than it is, I think, to go to class sometimes.
God damn it!
What?
What?
I opened one of.
John Cena.
I opened one of my web pages and then the John Cena extension came up.
Damn it,
and it
John.
Scared the shit out of me. I was just looking something up. And then I just hear the blaring, and his name is John Cena.
Oh.
Why do I do this to myself?
It's one of the dumbest memes of late.
But yeah, because what I was saying was I think it's a lot better to learn things on your own because I was like, oh yeah,
absolutely.
I'm a huge Beatles fan. I'm going to learn a bunch of George Harrison stuff. So I went around and you know, I learned I Feel Fine and Day Tripper and stuff like that. And then I was like, okay, cool. I learned While My Guitar Gently Weeps and stuff like that. And then while I was always a huge Van Halen fan, and it's really difficult, let's learn Hot for Teacher. So I figured out Hot for Teacher. And then, you know, like, fucking Jamie's Crying or Feel Your Love Tonight and stuff like that. So I was like, yeah, I love Van Halen. And then it's like, yeah, I'm a huge Rush fan too. I learned Overture in 2112 and
holy shit.
Yeah, Passage to Bangkok. And it's like, yeah, these are great fucking
like,
songs.
Definitely, I feel like as a musician, I'm always more impressed with people who have taught themselves because that was always driven by passion than just taking classes. Like, not to say, like, people who are passionate don't take music classes as well, because there are some really talented people.
Oh, yeah. In high school, I knew a lot of guitar players, just because of the people I hung out with. And there was obviously a difference between people that... I was the person that, you know, taught themselves completely, never took a single class on it. Then there was a person that took classes and didn't really teach themselves, kind of like try to learn songs by themselves, but for the most part they took classes. And then there was a guy that was in between. He forced himself to take classes, so he learned, you know, the rudiments and stuff like that, and stuff like that, and then taught himself some more, because he was telling me his second song he ever learned was YYZ, which is incredible to hear as your second song to ever learn. And he's, last time I heard him, he's an amazing fucking guitar player. He's just incredible. I feel bad he's not in a band or anything at the moment because he's always busy with work and shit, but he was just a great guitar player. It's really strange, but I always hated those people that learned
John.
Just from classes. No, like, this is an actual
John.
Thing.
What?
You guys are fuckheads. No, but in high school, there was this chick that I went to high school with, and everyone knew she was like the music person. She was known as the music person because she was in band and she was like the only guitar player and blah, 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 blah. But I never knew her as the musician because compared to the people I knew, she wasn't good. She could just look at a piece of paper that laid out everything and she would just read it off of that. Yeah, she played Don't Fear the Reaper, but she read it off a book. Where, right. You know, I knew people, it's like, yeah, I played Don't Fear the Reaper by listening to it. I didn't fucking read it out of a book.
It's kind of hard to compare because it's just like people's minds work differently too. Like
a stupid mind.
Hey man, it's like, you know, some people are visual learners and some people learn from listening more.
And some people just don't give a fuck.
Yeah, some people don't learn.
All right, and now I guess I'll do my last topic.
Finally!
I'm going to do my last topic because I know you guys don't want to talk about music, but I could sit here and talk forever.
Okay, but I'm going to silently be chanting Fallout 4 while you're talking about it.
All right. So, I'm a huge Rwby fan. If you don't know what Rwby is, definitely go check out Rwby. It's an amazing show.
It's a thing.
I'm trying to get these guys to watch it because I really do think if they were to sit down and watch... Damn it, Zane, shut the hell up! I'm really trying to get these guys to watch Rwby because I know them, and I know if they were to start watching it and like
you didn't even know I was allergic to dairy.
Shut up! Shut up! I'm trying to talk. And I know that if they were to sit down and like watch the episodes like all in one shot, not to just watch it like a little bit here, a little bit there, I know they would fall in love with it too and do it. And I'm hoping after John is done his Yu-Gi-Oh run, because I was doing that too before I got to the part where I just couldn't take it. I'm hoping they're going to just kind of shoot it like a movie go through it like a movie, because I believe they would totally enjoy it. And it is a great series. So that's my Rwby talk. And before we get into John's talks, because I know it's going to be boring.
Who knows, going to be boring?
It's just going to be very one-sided, probably.
Do we have any games by Zane this week?
I think we've been talking long enough that we don't need a game to fill time.
It wasn't to fill time, it was just because I wanted to play a game.
No, Alex, me and you are going to play a game while John's talking. Okay. But it's going to be a silent game.
Aw, you bitch.
So you're not actually gonna know until it ends. But what?
Oh, that's a great idea. All right, no, all right, John, start it.
All right, so I'll start off with the story that's a little more timeless than what's been going on in the news recently. So, for every 2 weeks in one of my classes, we have a team story where we go out and we come up with a story idea, then we go and make it happen for a week. And so this time around, we were pretty much screwed because nobody was calling us back until like Tuesday and the deadline was Thursday. So Tuesday morning, we got in a new pitch idea. So we just started working. Alex?
What? You're not supposed to be looking at me.
I can't stop looking. I have Skype up on my main monitor next to my notes.
Did I win again?
God. Keep going.
So Tuesday we had a story that actually got approved. So we just started working on that nonstop. And Tuesday we, Alex,
what
is this, a magic trick?
No, keep going.
Okay. So Tuesday we went to the Humane Society's fundraiser, which is what we ended up doing our story on. And I can't take you seriously when you stick a fist through your fist.
Through my fist? Fist through my fist?
Yeah, that's kind of what you did.
Okay.
Isn't it?
No.
Zane brought up Microsoft Paint.
Yeah, okay. John, keep talking.
Okay. So, if you haven't heard, the University of Missouri went through quite a bit of news like recently, and that is a university that I happen to attend. And basically Monday we were on the front page of Fox News, Yahoo News, Al Jazeera, BBC News America, ESPN, CBS, MSNBC, CNN, and the New York Times, and probably a lot more that I just never saw. But basically we had a hunger strike that happened on my university, And it was protesting a bunch of, well, what they were saying is they were protesting a couple of racist incidents and the lack of response from our administration. But I don't know, like, this is definitely an issue that I probably don't want to comment on very much at all. But I was at the epicenter. My bus pulls out. Is that electrical tape on your tongue, Alex? What the fuck are you doing? So what has been going on? There was a bunch of protests that happened right at a quad that is right next to my bus stop, and there were news trucks everywhere. There were more satellite dishes than I have ever seen.
What are you doing, Alex? I'm not even paying attention. I'm drawing in paint.
It's like a chip clip or something on his lips. It looked like.
Okay, so there were hunger strikes because your administration has been responding to your racist-ass state. Okay.
No, but see, the whole thing was they actually issued a news release a month ago. Not even a month ago before the hunger strike started. And from there, like, they said that, like, we acknowledge that these incidents occurred. We are in the process of doing something about it. We are, like, going to be making a program or something like that. And, like, they had just announced it that day, and, like, not even a month later, like, everything, like, we're on the front page of every news outlet I can think of. So, I don't know. The whole thing has just really been pretty, pretty damn crazy. Like, the guy that actually started the whole thing, Jonathan Butler, he started the hunger strike, and then a bunch of, like, 10 other people got involved, and they were kind of like the central 11 people for the Concerned Student 1950 movement. And basically, from, like, a student perspective, this was really kind of disruptive, I would say. And, like, what did it really accomplish? Because I don't, the entire incident stemmed off of a couple of students that made racist remarks. And what the hell can the administration do about that? Like, congratulations, you took out is a very murderous word. You made...
Take me out.
Take exactly. me you, out tonight.
You made our system president, which I'd like to note is not just our university president, but also, like, is in charge of, like, probably 70,000 other students that do not go to this university. So he resigned. And we need a new one for that. And then it came out later that evening that our chancellor is stepping down too, which is just our university's head. But, like, why? Why is Lofton stepping down too? Like, we were sitting in the newsroom at the time because we were working our butts off with our story. And every time the broadcast came on from campus, we just unmuted one of the four TVs that we have constantly going in our newsroom, and we just listened to the broadcast, and they announced that the chancellor was stepping down, and it was very, like, wow, that, why? And so Tuesday things got at least a little more interesting, because Tuesday we got a bunch of, like, media now also trying to cover it, because, like, after it's been on the front page of everything, of course, all of the people are also going to continue covering it later the next day. And you have probably seen a video, or maybe on Twitter, of a professor yelling for muscle when a reporter was going near. A student reporter, I'd also like to say. A student reporter is trying to go to the little tent.
Did you know him?
I don't know. His voice did not sound familiar, but...
Did you know her?
No, I didn't know the professor either. But
then what do you know?
What do I know? That it happened, like, as I sit in my bus waiting to go home, I just look to my left and everything was right there. Like, when I came home today, I just sat down on the bus, looked to my left, and I'm just like, God damn, what a week it's been. Yeah, so Tuesday, that all happened. That also got quite a bit of social media attention. And, of course, they were on public ground, so legally they didn't have much ground to stand on. But no, they boxed reporters in and started harassing them, what looked like. So that was definitely fun to watch and gave me a lot of hope. And when Tuesday night is when things actually started getting at least a little bit scary. Rumors started flying everywhere about the KKK being in Greektown.
Wait,
something.
You don't have the KKK around you?
No, it was just a rumor.
Really?
And then somebody was saying that they could, like, they sent a message saying, some of you are nice people, don't show up to school tomorrow, which was obviously kind
of
scary.
Some
of
you are nice people.
Yeah, some people, like, I think the context of that was somebody, maybe an Oklahoma shooting happened. Like, the guy posted one of those really similar messages on 4chan. And the next day, like, stuff actually got shot up. So there was that. There was apparently a bunch of commotion going on in one of our areas where we have a bunch of, like, unlimited free speech. Or not unlimited, like, we have a...
Limited. Limited free speech.
Well, free speech is limited.
You can only speak for 5 seconds a person.
No, like, we have an area specifically on campus that you can stand in and speak your mind. And that is an area where a lot of, like, the religious preachers go and they talk a lot there. It's also a place where they pass out a crap ton of media, like mini Bibles and stuff. But that's like other weeks. This week, apparently there was something going on there. I don't remember too much of the context with that. But basically, a lot of shit was, like, threatened. And so the next morning, when I got to school, I ended up going, because if I was going to let terror drive my life, I don't want to do that. That seems like a terrible way to do things.
Oh, I thought you did it just because you actually had class and shit to deal with. You're too busy to deal with that shit.
That was kind of a reason I had to return equipment, but no, like, if I didn't want to go to class, that would have been the day not to, because, like, our class has probably 25 to 30 people in it, and whenever we got there, there was, like, 2 minutes until we usually start, which is right at 8 o'clock. There were 4 people in the classroom, and then 3 people walked in, like, 3 students. We had 3 faculty leaders in the room. And so we just scrapped the entire lesson of the day, which is supposed to be, like, interviewing the data. So, like, how do we find people for data stories and stuff like that? But when it comes to that class, we just kind of sat around. We talked about why we even showed up in the first place and talked about the events that have been going on. And I don't know, like, it's things like that that make, like, these kind of events more interesting than usual, just because, like, yeah, all this stuff is going on, people are working their butts off, but and everybody's exhausted because of it, but, like, just the natural conversations that come out of it seem very nice to talk about, and, like, just not scheduled, not just very open and stuff like that. So that happened, and then we went to the Futures Lab, which is our newsroom, and we went to what day was this? This was Wednesday. So we went to the animal shelter, which is the place that we need to get video of for our story. We came back, and apparently there was going to be a march that evening. We Are Not Afraid by the protesters. So I wasn't there for that, but they were marching out, and there was a really pretty big storm front coming in, which I imagine that's why they took down the tents that following night. Or the night before that. So there was a pretty big storm that was going to be brewing. Nothing really happened, but there was, like, potentials for tornadoes and stuff.
Man,
so
it'd been a huge shame if a tornado went there and killed everyone that was protesting.
Yeah, but it would also
real
wipe...
a big shame.
It'd also wipe out part of the campus, so thank you.
Yeah, I mean, well, those people would be gone out of the way.
Have good intentions, just...
No, they really didn't.
Yeah. So,
how is end racism a bad intention? They just went about it the wrong way.
Yeah,
is there even a right way to go about it, man? Because
that's my main criticism. Like, the whole thing, I feel like, caused way more of a rift than it did fix any problems. Because then they have established that you can just protest and get your way, no matter how much, like, it doesn't make sense. Like, honestly, with what they've sent out before, I don't see any reason why they should have fired. or not fired, but pressured to step down the two people that did. And in addition to that, like, they were kind of doing it in probably the worst way possible, because both they were restricting people's constitutional rights. So that was one thing. Another thing is they boxed in a car, which I think was carrying Tim Wolf, which is the guy that stepped down. And so, like, they were almost like illegally detaining him in a sense.
That is illegally detaining him.
People are stupid when they're passionate.
Well, I have a question. Could they not all be sued and thrown in jail for doing some of those things?
I doubt any of that would ever happen.
You want to bet? I would
love to see somebody try.
Dude, that's why you don't fuck with people. Dude, that's why if something like that were to happen here, that would not go down. I'm telling you, that wouldn't go down.
Yeah. Like, so they were doing that. They, what else was something that, that didn't make a whole lot of sense? They made demands that in general, like, were kind of confusing. Like, they wanted more representation in the staff than percentage
black
students. Yeah. Like, it's only 2%, but it's still taking away representation from other people. Like, if they want equal representation, why not ask for what percentage of students is going on? And they also don't realize, like, there was this video that I watched of Thunderfoot that I showed it to you guys, and he talked about how,
I don't know, but he's got some balls on him.
Yeah, he does that a lot for, like, feminists and creationists and stuff like that.
Which is weird, because I believe feminism is a good thing. I don't believe what people do now is a good thing, but the original idea of feminism is a good concept. Everyone should be equal across the board is what it means. But that's not what they're doing nowadays. That's the issue. They're going beyond equilibrium.
Yeah, they're going, like, that's one of the things is, like, that you have this huge uproar and then you were having them ask for more than equal representation and, like, proportional representation and stuff like that. And I don't know, this might just be way off base, because I am, as they would probably call me, a cis white
scum.
Exactly. But I don't know, this just seems like really out there and just wait, this isn't the way to do it.
I'm just gonna tell you one of the things that if someone said that to me, like, face to face, that you're a cis scum and actually meant it, I would beat the ever living shit out of them. I'm not gonna lie, come at me.
Yeah, like, one of the things that I heard a lot was, I don't feel safe anymore, and people are saying, like, this is not at all helping. This is just harming their cause. They're shooting themselves in the foot. And that's kind of the way that I saw it too. Like, they basically made our university look like a bunch of hypocrites.
Yeah, which you guys are.
Thank you.
No problem.
Honestly, it's like, I feel like they're trying to come from a good place, but it's just, the way to do it isn't this. Like, honestly, the best way we have right now, it's slow, it sucks, but it's just informing people on what's going on. And
right, and that's the thing, like, one of the points I heard is, like, be the change that you want to see, but that means, like, be like Barack Obama and become the most powerful man in the world, some could argue, not like join as a mob and make people who barely had anything to do with student comments resign. Like,
honestly, that's not going to have to do with something that the university has. That's just straight up upbringing.
I really don't get it. Let's see.
Now, what would happen if say the university did change and try to make it in their version of equal, which would be giving them more and taken away from someone else, and then that group of people had an upbringing and say, well, why are you doing that to us? What would happen at that point if they tried to have a giant riot about racism?
I don't understand this.
That'd kind of be hilarious, because we have an overrepresentation of Asian professors. Where's that uproar?
Yeah.
Where's the uproar from the white students that...
No, I can tell you right now
stuff
the
like
argument.
That.
It's all about history. White people have always been kind of shit to other people until, like, you know.
That's with everyone. That's with everyone. Everyone's that way.
No, here's the thing, though.
It's not just white people.
The whites won.
It's not just white people.
The whites won. That's why we're the assholes.
Boo hoo fucking who. You know what? It's so dumb. You know, I always hated the fact when growing up in here, it's like, well, you know, white people enslaved black people. Fucking at that time, black people enslaved black people. It's no difference. Everyone was enslaving everyone. It just happened to be that that those people got
it's
the raw end
of
the stick.
It's about who's big and who won, who made the biggest noise. America made a lot of noise,
yeah,
and we did a lot of shit.
But
we had a fucking war over slavery.
Yeah, I understand
right.
that. And I don't agree with slavery, but Jesus Christ, people need to shut the fuck up over it. It's fucking 2015.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
not 1815.
People are yelling at people. Yeah, people are yelling at people for stuff that, like, they had no hand in. Like, I really don't have any, like, concrete account
yeah.
of this, but
the only thing...
I have definitely heard people saying, like, they did not feel at all welcome in the quad where they had a camp set up because they were white.
Yeah, honestly, like, one thing big I don't understand, like, this podcast has been way off course now, but it's just like,
what happened to Fallout 4?
African Americans who constantly bring up, like, their ancestors were brought here against their will, like, yeah, and then going on about how, oh, I'm sorry, we weren't supposed to be in America, but you brought us here forcefully. It's like, okay, that was generations ago. Would you honestly like to live in Africa instead?
You know what? Put them there. If they're going to act like that, why don't you go fly back there? You know, really
I just don't understand. Like, I get it. Things are bad for them in America sometimes. Racism is a thing. But it's them just bringing up the fact that it's like, oh,
you
guys brought us here, now we're here.
Let me tell you a
like,
secret of the world, man. You're not going to believe this. There's racism fucking everywhere. You're
yeah,
never going
to escape. You're not going to eradicate this. This is a problem that you cannot just fix with two people leaving. This is seriously a problem that will take so long to fix.
There's never going to be a point in history where racism's completely gone. There's never going to be a point in history where sexism's gone.
Yeah.
It's just how the way the world works. I'm sorry.
It's how we're biologically wired
who.
To group
best
stuff together.
Best we can do is be good people in ourselves.
Exactly.
Hold ourselves to high standards and just not talk to people who don't share similar standards.
No, you can still talk to, like, you guys and me.
Don't make them close.
No, you guys and me don't see eye to eye with certain opinions, but we can still talk about them because, you know, we're fine with that. We're not killing each other. But Jesus Christ.
Yeah, just be respectful.
Yeah, but Jesus Christ, these fucking people. And that's what really pisses me off, especially when it's with feminists trying to do, like, over exaggeration of it, because you're not really a fucking feminist at that point. I fucking am a feminist, and that's a fucking nuisance.
Yeah, the name is like, I agree with the ideals of feminism. Like, I see women as equal in every single regard. I can't think of a single way besides, like, maybe legal advantages of being a woman. Like,
no, there's, don't, you don't want to get into that, man.
I'm talking about, like, child custody, less time
yeah, yeah,
for the same crime, stuff like that.
Yeah, that's all positive side for women.
Yeah.
And it's straight, like, up sexist.
Just stuff like that.
It is. It's funny because I got a funny story about that. We were having a family thing, and I come from a very Italian family, and
Italian.
Yeah, and so there's a bunch of us, and my grandmother said something about how women need to be in the kitchen. My grandmother said this. And my brother goes, I'm with you, Grandma. And, like, my aunt's like, we got rid of that. Women are equal now. And she goes, that's not true. They're trying to get more than equality, and it's not right. We just need to go back in the old
time. Honestly, I think it has a huge thing to do with perception too.
Perception, yeah.
Because it's like one group can prove somewhat. And perceive someone as equal, like, yeah, we're giving them all the same stuff, but someone else can go, no, there's these problems underlying that we're perceiving this, and this isn't equality, this is, you're still getting,
like, why do
deal.
They get vaginas? Come on, that's not even fair.
God damn it.
How did this podcast
like
get so serious?
Welcome to the White Guilt Podcast.
Yeah, I feel bad for being white sometimes.
I don't. Well, I'm also the darkest one here.
It's like Louis C.K., what would you choose? White every time.
It was Chris Rock who was like saying that he's rich, but there's not a single white person who would like change lives with him that he's talked to.
Chris Rock?
Like, you could talk to someone who's working at, like, you know, McDonald's and who's white and just like, would you trade lives with me? It's just like, I don't know, man. Like, I want to ride this white thing out.
I want to ride this white thing out.
Hey, man.
Jesus Christ. Can this podcast either be titled either Zane Fucks Kids or Zane Wants to Ride This White Thing Out?
We need to insert something that goes, okay, everyone, this is now going to get like super serious and not fun. If you want to hear rants from white people.
You can either hear about...
Not for some people. We're going to get hate for this if we get
popular. You either talk about fucking children or riding this white wave out.
I'd rather talk about fucking children because at least people know I'm joking about that and like that's not going to be me. But here people are going to go, oh, here's his opinions on these popular things and they're just being dumb white people who don't understand. And it's like, man, I'm trying to understand. I read things, I see some of your points of views, but at the same time, on a large part, I don't agree with some things that you do.
Oh my god. Oh no.
At least it's returning back to the more funny stuff.
The way
just
you
trying
said
to be liked. I'm trying to be a good person.
The way you said that, man. Come on.
I know.
You know that's a perfect sound bit now of you just screaming, I want to talk about fucking children.
I know.
The way you said that, man.
I know it was bad, but I was too passionate.
I am passionate
the proper
about
way
the
to
children.
No, passionate. Not that.
Let's go back to Extra Life.
God damn it. I can't win.
No, you're not.
No.
You're
I'm white cis scum. I can't win.
You're never going to win. Holy shit, this podcast is...
Like, the only way to win is if you're someone who's just like, ah, yeah, women and power and blah, blah, blah. Beat the... Well, maybe not always, like, beat those men, but, like, don't let a man hold you back, blah, blah, blah. It's like, yeah. That's true, but that's not something I'm gonna be going out loud. Just like, girls, you gotta go step up, be who you gotta be. And shit, I'm just gonna be like, yeah, just like live your life and don't let people shit on you.
Yeah. Like, one of the things that I've noticed is like, we're pretty damn sensitive. Like,
I'm not sensitive.
Oh, yeah.
Screw that.
No, like,
no,
I'm
like,
talking about people. Yeah, as a culture and like, as people
we
at my university.
Way more sensitive. I'm not saying, I'm not one of those people who's like, oh my god, comedy is getting way too sensitive, it's dumb, blah, blah, blah. No, like, I'm fine with our comedy nowadays.
Yeah, like...
I'm fine with not making fun of someone being Jewish.
Oh no, I'll
comedy in some
funny
sense is going to offend somebody.
Dude, if you're offended by a joke, kill yourself. Screw off.
Oh,
it's
so
a
gonna
joke.
Be offended by you saying
it's a joke, screw off.
This is also coming from people who, like, have been on the internet for how long?
We're
so long that, like... We have really tough skins, but just like...
Yeah.
No, this isn't like that. This is just for the fact of dealing with people. I come from a hardworking area where the people are very... I don't want to say very similar, but they are somewhat similar with these topics. People need to chill the fuck out. They really do. And it's really annoying to deal with all these fucking pussies about it. It really is.
Yeah, like... I get...
You know,
in some sense, like, you obviously don't want to be called racial slurs, but at the same time, like...
You know what?
Like,
John, you're fucking honky.
I think you need to show some sensitivity to a point, but you don't need to go to the extreme.
Yeah, really. I do understand...
Like, at this point, you're policing what people say.
Yeah, like, I don't mind not saying certain things. Like, I'll joke around and say certain things, like, that I'm not going to say here... That I might have said earlier, but you know, I say it as jokes. I never say it in all seriousness, trying to like hurt people. But
I think with this point, like
honestly, like just come up with some good comebacks. Like if someone calls you the N-word, just call them a cousin fucker.
That's
exactly.
But then, what do they do when they actually are one?
When they are a cousin fucker?
Yeah.
Well, then they go. It's not bad, okay? And it's like.
Well, hold on. Why did you use that accent?
Stereotypes.
Racist.
Yep. It's okay to be racist against white people, though, especially when you're
South,
white.
I'm from the South, you dick.
Yeah, he has a point. Apparently, it's fine.
I'm right next to West Virginia. I get it.
I am in the South.
If you're listening to this podcast, don't fuck your cousin.
but Zane's all about the children.
No, don't do that either. I don't endorse that.
Yeah, I mean, I don't even think you donated to Child's Play, man.
Okay. Here's your flaw in your logic. If I was really what you are jokingly saying I am, a child fucker, I would want them to be healthy. I don't want to catch no disease. So there's the flaw in your argument. Once again, I do not fuck children. I straight up do not fuck
children.
No, straight up, just I have not. Nope.
Hasn't happened for
nope.
you.
Nope.
Oh my god.
This, me too.
This made a really...
I'm okay with that.
Oh god, this turned pretty quickly.
I'm just glad we're finally at a point where we can laugh again.
What a podcast.
Oh god, this has been a roller coaster.
So Fallout 4?
Fallout 4, yeah, I fucking love that game.
I might actually go get it just to forget all the troubles from this week.
That and drinking a lot helps.
Yeah. For those of you who think we're white cis scum, I love Fallout 4, and I think it's cool that at the beginning bit, there is a couple that people have been thinking has been a lesbian couple at the beginning when you're running to the vault, so...
And if you think I'm white cis scum, you don't even know me.
If you
assholes.
Think Alex is white cis
I'm
scum,
black.
You're probably right.
No.
He's Italian.
Yeah, I'm really dark, though.
Yeah, if there's one week that made me want to go get drinks, it was this week. Because every day... I was almost like food was a second priority to all of the shit I had to do.
You can't eat food, so go get drunk.
Yeah, and another thing to point out myselfness, I have longer hair than some girls, so yeah.
That doesn't mean anything.
He's breaking down the barriers of gender.
I'm
behind him.
Dude, this chick sits next to me in one of my classes, my materials classes. She has like super short hair, and it's funny. And she's short, where I'm, you know, yeah. I'm tall.
I love those with short hair.
And she, and I'll just, like, I'll take my hair out of a ponytail, and then I'll just have my hair flop everywhere. So there's this chick with super short hair, and then there's me with super long hair.
Hey, man, I'm just saying, like, back in the day, guys used to have super long hair, like fucking Vikings. Gorgeous.
Dude, I am a Viking.
Excuse me, I'm the Minnesotan. I'm the only.
It's actually it's called Strongman Americans. Get it right. Come on, you're gonna hurt my feelings, you sis scum.
Yeah. While we were talking about all this seriousness, I drew this lovely picture.
I know my favorite part was.
Yeah, you need to send me that so I can put it in the
orgasm,
description.
Orgasm. Does it say orgasm master or orgasms matter?
Both, but it says orgasm master.
All right.
For those of you
inches?
Who don't want to click the link, it
inches?
Is the
really?
Boob cock.
90 inches?
Yep.
Man.
90 inches, 10 of 10.
Have you seen the quadruple D?
No. I like how you had to write out cum.
Well, yeah, just so no one...
Has science gone too far? Who knows?
Guys!
But...
I just got my album delivered.
Oh yeah!
Yay.
What album?
It's the album that I've listened to the most, like of any music album.
K-pop.
It is K-pop.
Another thing breaking down the barriers. John appreciates music from other cultures.
Yeah.
I mostly listen to music from other cultures.
Well, I mean, technically, I do too, but just.
I feel like we're almost
English
trying to make the
culture.
Excuse. Like, I have a black friend, so I can't be racist.
Well, yours might be Korean. Mine's British. So it's all, you know.
Right, even things that can be... Never mind.
And sometimes...
I don't want to talk about
and
it.
And Canadian.
I drive a car that was made in Japan. I'm cultured.
Okay, don't drive Japanese cars. Let's be real here.
Toyota, man.
Dude, no. American cars.
Dude, fuck American cars.
I drive a Jeep!
I like Jeeps.
Well, like trains.
All right, is this how we're calling it? So, let's backtrack real quick to
if you
people.
Want to insult us, email us at
www.whitecyst.com.
No, whitecyst. Shit, I can't even say it now. whitecystscum.com/the Whizzler.
I don't.
Whiz, it's time to whiz.